Okay. Hello, everyone, everywhere in the world, and welcome to the second episode of my Weird Wednesday. Thank you to all of you for all the interest. Thank you for all the views. We have a total of 485 views in total in the aggregate of the channel. Well, I know that we have talked about some controversial topics last week, and I assume that is the reason why these videos haven't been as successful as I thought they would be. Well, never mind. I considered it was necessary for you to know about the situation that we are experiencing here in this part of the world. Well, first of all, as you can see, we have a different environment tonight. It's not a new background only. We are in a different place. We are in a restaurant, a gourmet restaurant here in Juliaca. And I want to thank Franklin Condori Cuno and Blanca Monroy Quiroz, who have given me the chance to be in this place tonight so I can record the video for you. This is Sumaki Grill Restaurant. This is a very nice place, and as you can see, maybe you can hear some background music. And well, this is a very nice place. The food here is exquisite, and I'm not just saying it. It's really good. We have something to show you about that. Look at this. This is passion fruit juice. It's very fresh and it's very refreshing too, and it's one of my favorites. You can have star fruit juice, you can have strawberry juice or pineapple juice or whatever you have. But not only that, you can also have grilled meat, grilled chicken or grilled pork. You can have also grilled beef. You can have kebabs also, and also the traditional anticuchos, that are a dish that you might find a little like disturbing, but they are made with a cow's heart that is seasoned. It's cut to pieces, of course, and all the pieces are seasoned and put in the skewers, and they are grilled. And so, well, it's what they call anticucci. Okay. We also have many different cocktails and pizza, many different kinds of pizza, and also pasta of many different kinds. So if you by chance have the opportunity to be here in Peru and you are around Juliaca, maybe you would like to try this. It's going to be really interesting. The service here is really nice. They have been really kind with me, and it's really interesting. So whenever you are in Puno, come to Juliaca and come to this place. The address, if you want to know, is Manuel Prado Street, 528 Manuel Prado Street, and it's really close to the Electro Puno office. Okay, so well, if you are ever in Peru, in Puno, well, why not try it? Well, after this, I feel that it's necessary for me to clarify some some mistakes, some erroneous data that I was that I gave last week about the assassination of our ex-mayor here in Juliaca, David Mamani Paricagua. First of all, he was not in Juliaca. He was in Puno, in the Yanamayo prison. And second of all, there have been some theories that were a little far-fetched, in my opinion, that he committed suicide, and it was completely discarded because of the autopsy, and the result, the outcome of that showed that all the injuries that he had were produced by another person. We still don't know who is the intellectual author of this, but well, I think we'll have to wait and see. And it's really pitiful for me. I would like to talk about more uplifting things, and we are going to do it in a moment. So well, there is a reason for me to be especially happy this week, because since last Monday we have started classes, and as you know, I'm an English teacher, and so that means that I think I have to discard this video because I'm okay. That was a false alarm. Okay, sorry. Well, it's a little late, I think I'm gonna do this a little more quickly. Okay, the Ministry of Education in this country has decreed that the beginning of classes this year would be March 13. And what I find really something that I find really interesting, and something that I really applaud for its initiative, is that they did so in spite of all the trouble that the climatological change has caused here in Peru. There have been floods everywhere, there have been very heavy rains in many different places all across the country, and Juliaca has not been an exception. And even so, I've seen kids going to school in a more or less normal way, but I think it's good that they don't use this wacky weather as an excuse. And I find that this is really, really, really good. Okay, this week I had the chance to be a part of a commemorative concert in memoriam of one of my personal friends who passed away last year. His name was Humberto Rojas Huancoyo. And I have the chance to meet this beautiful, wonderful person, who was someone who was always smiling. He was like Mr. Smiley. He was always very optimistic. He was very charismatic, and it was something that I think I've learned from him, to be always hopeful for the future. And I have a chance to get to see again many people that I haven't seen for a long while, and I think it was something really, really interesting. And now I've started singing again in a Latin American group, and so now I'm again on the road of what I like to do, because I really like my job as a teacher, and I really like the chance to be on stage as a singer or as a musician, because it's something that allows me to share my talent with other people, or my knowledge, or my artistic way of feeling with the people around me. And I think that you have noticed that I have many videos in the channel that feature your humble servant singing in different contexts. If you haven't seen them, I invite you to do so. And well, this is something that I really like to do, and I have the privilege to say that I like what I do, and I do what I like. And well, what do I think about this situation? Well, I feel that it's something that is really pitiful for me. It's pitiful to see that politics, not only in my country, but this is, I think this is worldwide, and this happens everywhere, regrettably. Politics is really rotten, really corrupted, and it's really sad to see that even a person who has a good will and good intentions to actually do something for his or her people ends up wallowing in this mud, in this environment that is so toxic. And well, it's worrying, to say the least, to me. And I really hope that the new generations actually do something about this. I find that many things that happen, many social crises that are happening, are because of that, because people are fed up of the situation everywhere in the world. They really want a change. And what I think about it is that we ourselves are the change. If we really want to change the world around us, we have to change first. And so I'm not just saying it. I know for sure this is something true. And well, now let's go with my weekly obsession. My weekly obsession is a song. The weather hasn't been as good as I would like it to be, and so I'm trying to make a shelter out of my favorite music. And one of the songs that I really like is one by Electric Light Orchestra, Mr. Bluescat, but I'm not talking about the original version. I'm talking about the 2012 remastering that was featuring in many different movies and also in commercials. And I really like that song, and it's been like a shelter for me, so I can get through this wacky weather. And there was some sunshine today, so it was like yeah, finally some sunlight. But well, it started raining in the afternoon, and so it was like, oh well, never mind. I think it was too good to be true, but well. Okay, so the weekly tip is about something that I find really moving, and it comes from IFL Science. I recommend you to follow this on Facebook and on Twitter and on the other social media that I have. And the article is called Why Losing a Dog Can Be Harder Than Losing a Relative or Friend. They have a very interesting and deep explanation of all the sociological, the ethological, and also the scientific background, the psychological relationship and stuff. This is a very interesting article that deserves a thorough reading. And I really recommend this to you. And this is one of my favorite things about this page. I follow this on Facebook, and it's really interesting because if you follow IFL Science, you are gonna learn a lot about the world and the universe around you. And I think it's gonna really blow your mind. Okay? Well, now let's talk about something in Spanish. There is a topic that is kind of tricky for most people who speak English. That is what we call in Spanish the assigned gender. That means that, for example, I have a pen in here, and we know that this object has no gender, has no a male or female representation, right? But in Spanish and in many other Romance languages that are derived from Latin, they have the feature of assigning a gender to objects. For example, this is el lapicero or la pluma, depending on the country we're talking about. And as you can see, el is a word used for males, and la is a word used for females. Okay? So it's really tricky. There are some rules of thumb that you can use. For example, most of the words, the nouns ending with an O are male. They have a male gender, right? And most of the nouns ending with an A or with another letter have this, have the opposite gender, the female gender. And so this is a very important feature if you really want to understand Spanish. I know that it's kind of nonsensical for you English speaking people, because you know that this is something neuter, a neuter gender. And this is something that I find a little arbitrary in Spanish, but well, it was like that in Latin, and Spanish derived from that. And so, it's just like that. It's just like the evolution of things. For example, I know that English comes from a Germanic root. And that's the reason why there are some things in English that are similar to German. So it's because of the evolution and the development of languages in different historical contexts that make these differences. Okay, so that's all for tonight. Thank you for all your views. Thank you for the 485 views this week. Thank you to all the people in the United States and in Germany who are watching us. Thank you to all the people in Mexico and in Argentina. And obviously, thank you to the 90% of people in my beloved country in Peru who watch these videos. And something, I've I've been told that there are some problems with the audio of the preceding videos, the videos that were uploaded before this. And so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do my best to have them ready for next week. I'm gonna make transcriptions of them, and I'm going to subtitle them, so it's gonna be easier for you to understand what I say. And I'm gonna try also to enhance the audio, so it's gonna be much better for you. I hope I am not gonna be forced to have to re-upload them, but well, if it happens, well, never mind. So thank you for your interest. Thank you for sharing, watching, for your comments, and thank you for everything. And keep on going, like always. See you next week.